Thank you for selecting the SparxLift helmet for your welding and grinding protection needs. This video will demonstrate how to adjust the settings on the SparxLift helmet. The SparxLift has four adjustable settings to meet your needs and preferences. The controls for these settings are glove-friendly and located on the left side of the helmet when worn. The top knob allows for adjustments between shades 9 and 13 by rotating the knob until the embossed arrow points to the desired shade. The higher the shade number, the darker the lens will be when the auto darkening filter is activated. It is important that the user understand that there is always full-time radiation and UV protection, and that shade 4 is provided even when the ADF is not activated. There is a recommended shade chart in the SparxLift manual for your convenience. The knob just below the shade knob controls the delay. The delay refers to the length of time it takes to recover from dark to light after a weld has been completed. During periods of short, rapid welding, it may be desirable to have a slow recovery to avoid flickering and the tired eye effect. The knob just below the delay knob controls the sensitivity. The higher that sensitivity, the less light is required to make the ADF activate. Conversely, the lower the sensitivity, the more light is required to make the ADF activate. Finally, just to the right of the delay and sensitivity knobs is the RF sensor adjustment. For TIG welding of less than 10 amps, the RF sensor should be set to high. This setting should also be used if using shielded cables and welders. For TIG welding of more than 10 amps, the RF sensor should be set to low. This setting should also be used when working near other welders or in areas of high RF interference to avoid false triggers and for general welding.